Good morning, my loves. Today is my, 26, 25 and a half, 26 week appointment. So we're gonna vlog as always. I have my computer on East Coast time still. So I have to do math. So I'm like, it is 11:30 in the morning. No, it's not. My appointment's at 10:50. It's 8:30 in the morning. I have to get a whole bunch of work done. I don't know why this morning I woke up feeling so stressed. Like, I'm gonna cry. Let me start by saying this. Up until now, second trimester, I've been in the best mood. Like, so much fun all the time. Playful. If somebody gets, Adam, is this somebody, snippy around me, you know, hangry or just having a bad day, I will like go above and beyond to try to make him laugh, to fix it. For the past like 2 days, I've felt the disgusting part of pregnancy. My feet and my ankles are swelling really, really bad. It feels like it's early. I'm 2 weeks still from the third trimester, but it's gotten to be 90 degrees in Las Vegas. And maybe I ate something funny yesterday that didn't agree with me, but by 6-7 o'clock at night, my feet, my ankles were just burning. They were so bloated. It's getting really hard to try on, to put on my shoes right now. Sorry, a coworker, I think, is IMing me to help me with an issue. Sorry. So I'm just feeling that yucky part. Yesterday I got up earlier than usual. Sundays are my early morning day to go to CrossFit. So there's only two things that get me out of bed early in the morning. Well, it's soon to be three things. That will be number one soon. But one, visiting Adam, when I used to go visit Adam. Two, a workout at my favorite gym. And three, flipped to number one, is a little man. He's gonna be up early. I don't know if that's contributing to it. I think it's probably a combination of everything. I'm starting to feel the yuckiness. The hormones of third trimester might be starting to kick in because I've been hitting milestones. Like, when I went from the first to second, I kind of felt like I was out of the ickiness of the first 10, 11 weeks versus 13, 14 weeks, where most people say you like actually retransition, because everybody's body's different. And I know that you can test differently. Like, maybe I'm testing 2 weeks ahead of schedule. I'm not sure, but I feel like the ickiness of the third is starting for me, and I'm like 25 and a half. And I heard that 27 or 28, depending on who you ask, is when the third starts. So it's gonna be a long summer. But this morning, I just feel very stressed. My boss has kind of been on me. I had an account that I couldn't get to work. That's who I was just IMing. I have a coworker that's helping me work through this issue. I don't know, I just feel like very antsy, very frenetic energy, if that makes sense. And then it's making me feel like I wanna cry. I think it's just a work stress on top of hormones. I have my diabetes test today. I double checked for my office. What they want me to do is eat normally how I normally would. Eat how I normally would prior to the test. Otherwise, they say it could mess up the results of the test. I'm not sure. So I have to go in. I believe what I do according to the paperwork that they gave me early on. It said that you drink the drink, I believe. I'll ask and see if they'll let me do gummy bears. I don't know if they have them or not, if that's available. Then you kind of sit around for an hour and wait for, I guess, to see how your body reacts. I'm not sure. And then I will FaceTime Adam from the office because he's not allowed to come into this appointment with me. And we will go from there. But I just wanted to check in, tell you how I'm feeling. I'm not stressed about my appointment. I kind of feel like I just need to get there. I want to dye my roots. And then I haven't dyed my roots in a long time. So my doctor says it's fine to dye my hair. FYI, side note, I know it's like a thing people get a little funky about. My doctor says it's fine. If I wasn't so gray, I'd probably just let the roots go for 9 months, but I can't stand seeing myself gray. I'm so energetic and happy. I swear, once I get there and get going and get this work thing behind me, we'll be good. All right, I love you guys. Okay, here's a quick update. I can't make this too long because I'm in the car and my phone is directly in the sun. So that was kind of dumb. It's gonna shut itself down if I'm not quick. So the glucose drink, I've heard so many mixed reviews, and the best way to describe it, so many people said it tastes like flat orange soda. It tastes exactly like the taste of orange soda, but there's no bubbles. So they gave me a choice of lime, fruit punch, or orange. I chose orange because I figured lime and the heartburn, fruit punch is so extra sweet. I don't mind orange soda. I mean, when I was younger, I would drink orange soda. they told me I had to wait an hour, but then Adam, I was in the waiting room and he texted me and he's like, can you talk? And I was like, sure, I'm just waiting. And as soon as he called me, I could hear them say my name, like talking about me behind the front desk. So I'm kind of like listening out of one ear to Adam. He's like, are you okay? And I was like, yeah. He's like, that was not convincing, but it wasn't that I'm not okay. I was just trying to multitask because they were talking about me. I figured they were calling me. And then the next thing, they called me to the back. That was probably, I don't know, 5 minutes after I drank my drink. Not long at all. And they give you 5 minutes, by the way, to drink it. And I downed it really quick because, ugh, I just wanted it over with. But you literally have to tell them when you're going to start. So I was like, listen, I'm just going to leave the drink. It looks like a little soda bottle. I'll put a picture in. I was like, I'll just leave the drink right here. I'm just going to run to the ladies room as long as you don't need to test my urine. She's like, yeah, that's fine. But just let me know when you start. So I walked out. I'm like, I started it. She's like, are you done? Like a minute in. So I did not do anything as far as like I was going to do a before and after screenshot of my phone. I didn't have time. I would just finish it really fast. Did that. They called me back. They took my weight and my blood pressure. I only gained 1 pound this time, but honestly, my belly's so much bigger. I think what happened was, not even I think, I know what happened was, last time at my anatomy scan, I was drinking water all day long. I ate a decent amount of fruit beforehand because people said that the sugar will make the baby move more and be more active and he'll cooperate during the anatomy scan. But then they did the anatomy scan. Everything was great. We had to wait an hour because the doctor we were supposed to be meeting with was in delivery. So Adam and I went out to lunch and I ate an enormous salad and it had like blueberries and shrimp and all this stuff. And my appointment was at like 4 o'clock in the afternoon. At this point, it's 5 o'clock. So all the food and water in my body from all day. And you know, you can fluctuate 8 to 10 pounds in just a day on the scale. This morning, my appointment was at 10 o'clock. I had only eaten breakfast and then maybe like a handful of nuts because I didn't want to have too much sugar beforehand. I drank maybe a liter and a half of water. So what happened was when they weighed me, it's just the difference of the matter of food and liquid in my system. I genuinely think I probably gained a couple pounds last time and this time I gained a little bit more. So it wasn't genuinely 10 pounds last time, if that makes sense, but that's okay. I feel great. My clothes are still fitting fine. My belly popped. It's big. I'm pregnant. I'm bloated. I'm pregnant. I gained weight. No big deal. My blood pressure was on the lower side again. It's not concerning to them. It's always low. Did that. Then they called me back into the exam room. I met with the nurse practitioner. We just talked about my swollen ankles. She said, I'm doing everything that I could already do. And the only thing that she can suggest is to put my feet up as much as possible. It's normal, unless the swelling is uneven, which mine is not, or there's a lot of pain, or there's any kind of redness or anything like that, I'm okay. If any of that happens, and this is more for you guys in the future, I just think for me, it's my genetics and it's normal swelling. But if any of that happens for you guys in the future, you have to go to the emergency room because you do have a risk. I'm gonna move this so it's not in the direct sun. You do have a risk of blood clots when you're pregnant. I've been getting cramps in my calves, Charlie horses, at night. Basically, the only thing I could do, which I'm doing everything already, I'm drinking a lot of water, I'm taking magnesium, I'm eating a banana every once in a while before bed. It didn't help or hurt it. It's just part of it. She said some people it's worse than others. For me, my dad gets cramps terribly and one of my sisters gets them all the time. I got them during puberty, so I guess it's hormone related. I'm not sure, but they went away and now they're back with pregnancy. It's just part of it for some people. My doctor came in and saw me. I didn't even FaceTime Adam. I didn't record it because it was like a minute. It's a teaching hospital and I'm fine with that. So she had a medical student with her. She just repeated everything the nurse practitioner said. The only thing that she added was that if I wanted to get really sexy compression socks, all three of us were women, so we were joking about it, then I could do that. That might help with the swelling when it gets bad, which I will. I'll just get them from Amazon. Oh, so I have one more appointment in 4 weeks and then I'll be far enough along that I go to every 2 weeks for a few weeks. Oh, I'm so impressed. There's a girl in the parking lot doing walking lunges. I don't know if she's with a trainer, but you go, girl. You go, girl. She's talking to somebody, so I guess she's with a trainer. Sorry, I get distracted by that stuff. So I made all my appointments throughout the remainder of my pregnancy. The doctor that I wanted to switch to is no longer in practice, so I'm this far in. I'm just gonna stick with them. Adam's not really happy about it, but I don't know what my options would be because all the other doctors on Google have really bad reviews. I got my blood drawn, so we'll know in 3 to 5 days. They also needed to test me for my thyroid because somebody had made a mark on my file that I have a thyroid condition and I'm on thyroid medication. And I'm like, nope, not me. She's like, yeah, I didn't think so. I said, well, maybe you're mixing it up because I have asthma and you guys prescribed me an inhaler. She goes, no, I didn't know about that. So I don't know what happened, but they tested me for, and this is normal. This was in the brochure from that, like the pre-printed brochure that I got at my first appointment. They test you this week for
your gestational diabetes, so you get a blood glucose test. They test you for your iron, because it is possible that late pregnancy can cause anemia. So they're testing my iron levels, and also they have to test you for syphilis. I was just tested at 8 weeks for every STD under the sun and every drug under the sun. Everything came back negative. Obviously, maybe not. I don't know if that's obvious. Maybe you guys that are medical people know, but this is me just making a guess. Well, I have two guesses. Either syphilis is so bad and maybe deadly for a baby that they can't play, or maybe it takes a certain amount of time to show up in your system. So like, even if they test you at 8 weeks, if they don't test you again, you could have had it and not tested positive for it. I don't know the answer. I'm making this all up, but those are my two guesses. Took my blood. The lady was such a doll face. I made all of my appointments and then I headed out. I FaceTimed Adam. Then when I got back to the car, I drove around to see if there was some place that I could eat. I found Greens and Protein, which is basically like a healthy food cafe here. I had no ill effects from the sugar. A lot of people said they get really tired. I had to wait an hour to get my blood drawn. I felt a little tired, but nothing more than normal pregnancy exhaustion. It's been 2 hours, so I stopped at Kohl's really quick because it's next door. I got a couple things for the nursery. Sorry, Adam, he told me not to buy anything. Oops. But they were like on sale. I have a card. I needed to complete some stuff for the nursery. So cute. I'm gonna do a reveal, but I'm so excited for his nursery. I stopped and I got a veggie wrap. I'm feeling a little bit tired. Nothing more than my average pregnancy exhaustion, fatigue when I get that, like when I lose my energy. So I'm gonna head towards home. It is gorgeous out. It is 80 degrees. I do need to stop and get some groceries, but I don't know if I'm gonna do that now. I'm so hot. I'm wearing sneakers because I don't have a pedicure. Either I'm gonna go home, change, eat, and then go back out, or just go on the way home. I'll probably just go on the way home. Just do it, because get it over with, right? We climb the greatest heights, jump down and have a fight, and that's all. Just a quick check-in. It's been about 3 hours and 10 minutes since my test. I'm just leaving the grocery store. I feel okay. I mean, I don't feel much more tired than usual. It just feels like a little bit of a lower energy day, but not falling asleep at the wheel or anything like that. But I think the difference for me is that I was told to eat normally throughout the day before my test. The other people that I believe were having the crashing problem after the glucose drink was when they were told to fast. So I think it like really spiked and crashed their blood sugar. I will be back with another check-in, I guess, after I eat, and then we'll go from there. Love you guys. Mwah. Jump down and have a fight. Okay, it's been about 3.5 hours since my test. I feel fine. Nothing more than the normal fatigue that you normally feel on a just like a tired day. I did sit down to eat. This is what I got. So it's a veggie wrap with a pickle. I didn't even know that was there. I was so excited. Somebody did post in one of the apps that if you do feel really exhausted, the doctor suggested eating like a lot of carbs after your appointment. Somebody else asked if she should go back to work after her appointment or not, because hers is scheduled tomorrow. I would have been fine to go back to work. I was a little tired, but nothing crazy. Two other people said the same thing. One other girl was like, I felt kind of gross. I just wanted to lay on the couch and rest. So I guess it's an individual thing. I'm gonna go finish eating. Thank you so much for following along on this journey with me. I have my next appointment in 4 weeks. I think it's like a lot of information at that appointment. Adam cannot come. It's not an ultrasound at all. So I will be able to FaceTime it and then hopefully record the screen. If you're not part of the family, do me a favor and hit that little circle there or the red box below so that doesn't pop up on the screen. If you're interested in other videos with me, just click one on the screen right now. And if you don't see those, just scroll back on my channel, watch whatever you want. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you in the next one. Mwah.